Hey, good afternoon, everybody. Driving into the park on this lovely Thursday afternoon. Hoping I can get something for dinner tonight. I really want to do a catch and cook for everybody. Everybody on here watching this channel seen me catch plenty of fish, but nobody's seen me cook or eat any of them. So, we'll see what happens, I guess. Just went through the gate, got the good old wave. Since I'm a pass holder, I barely have to stop anymore. Check out the middle dock here, like we always start at. Hopefully the middle dock doesn't have anybody on it today. I came out here yesterday, but I didn't get a chance to do any filming. And of course, I actually didn't have any bait yesterday, so I came out here and just threw the cast net. I didn't actually see anything to throw at, but accidentally I got two things that I've never caught before. I caught a Atlantic spade fish and a yellowfin brim, yellowfin brim. And took them home last night. They were both big enough to keep. So, the spade fish was very easy to clean, and if I catch any more of those in the future, I will definitely keep them. The brim, to me, was a real pain to clean, so I don't know if I'll keep those anymore, unless I get one that was even bigger than the one I caught yesterday. The bigger they are, the easier it would be to clean, but still, I did not like cleaning it. And it might be because I filleted it as opposed to just cooking it whole. So that may be my next goal. If I decide to keep one, I'll just take the head off and end up cooking it whole. But all right, well, let's get out here on the dock and see what happens today. All right, I got set up here on the dock. I got the pole out on the line already with a fresh shrimp on it. I had to stop at the bait shop today and get another match of live shrimp, so that'll be good because I'll have frozen shrimp for a while still after this. Nice empty dock. I did bring the cast net with me, so I think I'm going to throw that a few times and see if I can get some more random fish. I don't see any mullet flipping anywhere though. Throwing, see if we surprise anything out there.
You let me know if I catch anything. Well, looks like still nothing. I went and grabbed a long sleeve shirt to keep the bugs off. And my hat. Something picked that shrimp off of there. It's a good sign. Something's out there, right? Work with the cast net. I don't mind having to throw the net down to reel the fish. Having to throw the net down to not reel the fish is annoying. tell if the pole just got off balance and fell over or something. No, 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 something's falling. Oh, wow. Oh, they got off. Damn. That was a shame. That felt really good, too. Hope whatever that was comes back and grabs it again. That's a nice opening. All right, how do I look? Dorky as ever, right? I wore it a ton last weekend camping, so the bug net smells like a campfire. The net definitely impedes the ability to see into the water. Big mullet jumping out there along that bank. I hope the camera caught that. It would really be nice to catch some mullet. I haven't had any mullet in months. Seen one or two last night. Just swimming by the dock real close. So too close to throw at. There's no sense in targeting just a single fish or the cast net anyway. Monster catfish. At least we're out here. This is a monster catfish. Whew! That might be my biggest catfish yet. And it's a sailcat. Oh, that's gonna be delicious. Just delicious. Oh,
Remember, always hold your catfish so that the spines can't stab you. He goes in the bucket. I don't really want to catch any more catfish, but a really big sailcat, I'm okay with. Another big fish jumping out there. School of sharks, so I'm right by my pole. Tearing up the mullet over there. School of black mullet. Oh, they landed on a yum now. Nope. They have a good size too.
least I know they're out there. Coin this the mullet walk, where you just walk back and forth across the dock, stop and look for a few minutes, switch places, doing the mullet walk. Switch places again. Second time this hat has caused that to happen.
Oh wait, there might be a fish on here. It's been on here this whole time. There's a little baby catfish there. Man, I bet he was on this line the whole time. He's a very, very tiny catfish. He's going back in the water. That's kind of funny. I bet he's been hanging out since that first time I saw the line twitch. But just not big enough to really pull it. The spike got me. Shit. Ugh. That's the first time I've been stabbed by a catfish. Oh my god, it hurts. Ugh. Oh my god, it hurts. Oh my god, it hurts. My whole head is in pain now. Oh my god. Ugh.
Oh. Oh. I've heard so many times online about how painful a catfish sting can be, and they weren't kidding. Oh God, my whole hand is throbbing. Oh, yep, I'm done for the night. Oh God. I don't even care. Oh, shit. Well, that's it. I think I'm going home. My whole hand is throbbing. Definitely no exaggeration of how bad these hurt. I'm back in the car. That hurts really bad. I can barely use that hand. The initial pain has subsided a little bit, but the throbbing is still there. Every time I try to really clench that hand or anything, it just hurts so bad. Oh, damn little catfish. Of all the things, a tiny, like, 6-inch catfish, something I can't even eat. Anyway, I'm heading home. Hope everyone enjoyed the video and you can learn something from my... I won't call it a mistake, because I was holding the catfish correctly. And then he slipped. And I tried to re-grab him again without paying attention. And his one gill fin or whatever just got me. They must have little barbs on the end that are just really small, because once it stuck me, it's like I couldn't get it out of my hand. And then the pain just continued to increase. But anyway, hope you enjoyed the video. I will catch you on the next one.